Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to make this image pop-up animation and aura effect using After Effects and Wondershare UniConverter. So let's get started. First, find the image that you want to use and save it to your computer. As you can see here, this image is very low resolution and has a lot of compression artifacts. So we're going to need to upscale and enhance it before we can use it in our edits. I'm going to be using Wondershare UniConverter, and if you want to follow along, I'll leave a link to download it in the description and the pinned comment. Wondershare UniConverter is an all-in-one professional grade tool made for content creators. It has a very beginner friendly and intuitive user interface, as well as lower system requirements compared to other software such as Topaz or Handbrake. UniConverter can do all sorts of things, ranging from media conversion and AI-powered compression to intelligent AI upscaling. For this video, I'm going to be using their image enhancement tool to make sure that our animation looks high quality. And a special thanks to Wondershare for sponsoring this segment of the video. Once you've downloaded UniConverter, open the Batch Image Editing tool and drag in your image. Then click on the Settings button and set the location of your output folder as well as the file format and click Confirm. Now you can enable the image enhancer, and after that's done processing, enable the image background remover. You can also use the basic adjustment feature to change the contrast, saturation, and brightness to your preference. I'm going to increase the brightness and contrast and lower the saturation. If you want to crop, rotate, or resize the image, you can also do that here, but I'm just going to click export. Here is the before and after. Now open up After Effects, drag in the image, and adjust its size and position. Then create a new solid layer and set it to whatever color you want. Make sure that the size of the layer is double the size of the composition. Now create a new null layer, and parent the solid and image layers to it by dragging the pick whip. Select the null layer, and while holding down Shift, click S and P to open up the scale and position properties. Then go to the start of the animation and create keyframes for both properties before dragging them to where you want the animation to end. Now you can position the layers off screen and set the scale to 35. Then select all the keyframes and easy ease them by clicking F9. Open the graph editor and then at the bottom click Edit Speed Graph. Drag the first influence to 25%. And then the second influence to 100%. Now, back in the timeline, select the solid layer and create an ellipse mask which is roughly the size of your image. And then apply this preset. For those of you who use After Effects 2024 or higher, I'll leave a link to download the preset in the description and the pinned comment. But for those of you who are using older versions of After Effects, I'll attach a screenshot of all the effects and settings. So once you've applied the preset, select both the image and the solid layer and press T to open up the opacity keyframes. Create a keyframe at the start of the image and set it to 0. And around 20 frames in, create a keyframe at 100 for the image. And another 15 frames in, create a keyframe at 100 for the solid. This is because I want the image to fade in faster than the aura effect in the background. Now I'm going to add a few extra effects to make the image look better. This step is entirely optional, but I recommend it to get the best result. Select the image layer and add the following effects: Deep Glow, Drop Shadow, Magic Bullet Looks, and CC Vignette. First, expand the Deep Glow effect and set the radius to 1000 and the exposure to 0.1. You can also add a tint if you want, but since my image is black and white, I'll leave it at the default glow. Now open the drop shadow effect and set the opacity and softness to 100. Then duplicate the effect and in the second one set the opacity to 50. Now open up the looks effect and click edit. Once a new window opens, click on the tools icon and drag in optical diffusion, gradient and clarity. We're going to leave the optical diffusion as it is, but for the gradient, set the color to black and set Y1 to 75%. And Y2 to -50%. Now go to the clarity effect and set it to 50% and click the tick mark to close the window. Now expand the CC vignette effect and set the amount to 70 and the effect center somewhere off to the side of the subject depending on where the light is coming from. So here is the final animation. Anyway guys, that's it for this video. I'll leave a link to download Wondershare UniConverter in the description and the pinned comment, as well as the aura effect preset and screenshot. If you want to see how to make a glitch zoom transition, click on this video and I'll see you there.